Hey folks, I'm back again with another video. I'm not in my usual place, so there may be some weird crap in the background or whatever, and I'll try to crop it out as best I can. But yeah, I wanted to sort of do a reply video or just an update to my video that I did on the project server, Project Lazarus. I think I said a lot of good things, but I also said that I was having a lot of issues, with having it, working properly, and that I was having a lot of lag. And the lag was mostly when I was, you know, trying to box six different characters. Now I can do that on the regular servers without any issues. But for some reason, on the Project Lazarus server, I was having nothing but problems. The lag was so bad, that it was unplayable, right? Level 24, Dark Elf Beast Lord. All right. And one of the things I really liked about Project Lazarus, or do like, is that a dark elf can be a beast lord, and they can have a cool-looking purple and black spider pet. You may recognize this spider model from Lost Dungeons of Norrath, I believe. You find them in the crypts, like the Mistmoor-style crypts with all the vampires and stuff. I've always liked this particular model. Big fan of the color purple here, and it just looks wicked as hell. And I'm glad they made it the Dark Elf's pet. And again, great server to play on, especially if you're not boxing. However, a lot of people kept telling me to check on my install, and that it sounds like I had a bad install somehow. And it's possible that I did. But I have since sort of reinstalled just about everything, and the only thing I left was my old UI files, because I really didn't want to have to completely overhaul the UI again, because it's so tiresome to do that every time. Ooh, there's, I think, a blue? Yeah. It does seem to be working better now. I haven't really gotten to test it. My English not so good today. I must have been drinking the caveman beer from the Buffy show. Anyway, that's a messed up reference. But I completely forgot what the hell I was talking about. Oh, I haven't gotten a chance to fully test, you know, my fresher install with six characters. Pardon. But playing it just with one, it's great. It's fine. It's fabulous. It's smooth. No problems. No notes. So, if this is a server you want to try and check out, you know, don't let my first video sway you from that. I wonder if I can kill this berserker. He's red to me. But I'm 24. Let's try. I can always run away. I mean, I got my pet, too. There are some awesome quality of life additions to Project Lazarus, which I didn't really get into, and maybe I should. You know, one is they do have, like, some nicer weapons, especially on the low end. I'm only level 24. You know, but I got this dagger that's 1020, and it's got some stats on it, or actually that's a orb. But there's a dagger too that's 819, similar. You know, and jewelry like this, like silver, gold jewelry, it drops off of ordinary monsters. Like, you don't really need to have a jeweler with crafting to get some cool jewelry. It drops off random mobs. So making money on here It's you're not limited to having the farm and kill nothing but hill giants all the time. Now you do gotta loot the old school way by right clicking, as you see, okay. But look at this, you know, I even got a braid, which maybe I could turn in later, because I am a dark elf, so I think I'm okay at that outpost. Yeah, I'm just apprehensive. So yeah, I was able to take out a red Sarnak Berserker with this character alone. So let me get into some of the quality of life aspects of this server that I really, really do admire. Now, first of all, let's look at the origin ability. You know, that when you go to advanced, alternate advancement, they do have origin. See, you can click on it, you can make your hotkey, and you can put it there. But it's a little different. This doesn't take you so much to the starting city as it does just POK. So, as an example, let's go to POK using origin. I mean, I know the book's right there, but you know, I want to display this ability, right? And once we're in POK, I could show you some of the cool things. I don't know if I got into it in my first video about Project Lazarus or not. So, yeah. So, see, here we are in POK. And so, no matter what city you're from, using Origin just takes you to POK. Which makes sense because you could get to any city from POK, right? And you're looking here on the right, you see all these crazy buffs I have, and all of them lasting over 4 hours. It's like, how do you get 4 hour buffs? Especially a 4 hour gift of pure thought, right? It's like unheard of. Well, that goes to one of the quality of life things on this awesome server. Here you go. You have this NPC called Buffs, or her name is Rubray, I guess. And it says Buffs for donations. So you go up to her, and you can hail her, and she talks to you, and she says hi, and if you'd want some buffs. And then the price of these buffs, they increase based on your level. So of course, you know, if you're a low level, they might be even free or just really super cheap, like a plat or less. Which again, getting plat is pretty easy on the server because there's a lot of like valuable drops that drop all the time on monsters here that you wouldn't normally see. Like a level one rat might actually drop like a silver fire emerald ring or something, you know? And then you can go to one of these, just any merchant, and you see that's 90 thief plat right there. So getting money is not hard at all. And they have their own kind of similar to like a simple or a rough defiant armor, because the stats are way better than the lowest tier, because this has hit point and mana regen. But you could get this if you do the tutorial, and it's, you know, it's got legs and so it's all got some stats, you know. And then they have quests where you can excuse me, get like a mid-level armor, I think, for your like 35-ish to 50-ish or something. And then there's a third quest for armor that's suitable for, I think, 60 plus or something like that. So very similar to regular live EverQuest, except, you know, it's free. It's you know, what, a project server, so you don't have to pay for it. These are some interesting NPCs also, where you could buy some ornaments and stuff. Oh, but so I showed you the buff person, and I might have showed some of this stuff in the previous video too, but let me show something else. Oh, and see, this is usually where you'd have mercenaries. This server doesn't have mercenaries. But they have these They changed the NPCs to like epic shaman ornament. I'm not really sure what that is. I'm assuming it's like a weapon appearance ornament that you would put on your weapon to make your weapon look like the shaman epic. So there's this guy here. This is normally where the serpent spine teleporter stone is, but instead you got this Valium guy, and he's Master Translocator. So you can walk up to him and hail him. Is it a hail? I think it's a hail. Yeah, okay. And he can teleport you to any zone, basically. You can click on all, and he gives you a list of all the zones. And any zone that you tell him to teleport you to, you want to make sure it's a zone where it's appropriate for your level. So I'm like 24, so like maybe I'd want to go to Mistmoor or Lava Storm, Lake of Ill Omen. Let's try Lake of Ill Omen. And boom, I'm going to Lake of Ill Omen. So here I am. And it's in the low level area of Lake of Ill Omen, so I'm not gonna get like completely beat down and killed right away. I can, go and find the higher level area. So let me bring up the map. And yes, the map works on this. This is definitely not the Project 1999 server with no maps. And I'm not trying to diss that server. I play on that server too, and I do like it. I do like feeling the classic EQ experience, but I am a player that prefers having a map because my sense of direction is not great, and I hate having to work up sense heading. I know you can do it just by binding sense heading to like your movement keys, so in no time you're gonna have 100 or 200 skill or whatever the max is for sense heading, but I still hate it. I still prefer the map. I don't care, whatever you want to say about me for liking maps, but we use maps in real life, don't we, folks? I drive for a living, and using navigation apps to get around, I wouldn't be able to do my job without it. So it's a normal thing to want. I'm pretty sure a lot of people that play EQ probably have used navigation apps at some point, especially when you go in a place that you're not super familiar with. And while I'm semi-familiar with certain parts of Lake of Ill Omen, I'm not familiar with this low-level part. I usually hang out over by the Sarnak Fortress. So I'm usually in the south side of Lake of Ill Omen, or if I'm at high level enough, I just make a beeline to Bexar. Pardon. So yeah, that translocator is handy, and he takes you to all the fabulous places in just a wave of his mighty fist. So yeah, try Project Lazarus. Tell me your experiences with it. Tell me if you ever have experiences with really severe lag. And tell me what you did to fix it. What I did was I pretty much just reinstalled everything. Pardon. Fresh. I did it. I didn't even erase my old stuff, my old install. I just copy pasted over the old install, and it just overwrote any of the files that it needed to, and that really did seem to help. It seemed to improve things greatly. And also, a side note, and it's late in the video, but my sound is probably going to be a little shitty. I don't have my good mic with me, but that's okay because the next video, I'll have my good mic again, and it should be back to normal without this weird background and stuff. So, again, Just a quick reminder, give some of these interesting project servers a chance if you want, especially if you don't have the money to play EverQuest on live servers. But if you prefer the live servers, do those. You know, I'm a firm believer that if you like a game, like the game in whatever iteration it takes. Don't let anyone else try to talk you out of it or say, oh, well, that's an inferior version of the game or whatever. I really dislike the elitist type attitude that some gamers have. You're still a gamer, dude, you know? You're still going to get your ass kicked if a bully comes along and messes with you. So, this is also why I don't like bullies either, you know? Oh, these guys are yellow to me. Okay, some good, let's end this video with either killing some stuff or getting killed. Hopefully my pet is not far behind, because I'm sure he is a good, at least 40% of my DPS. Let me make sure he's got his little procking buff. Yeah, there he goes. So, I think I'm going to survive. No, maybe not. Actually, I'm down to, like, low. I'm pretty low on health. I might need to run, or I might need to die. Okay. Let's kill the other blue, and then we'll either try to run away from the yellow, or we'll kill the yellow, because I'm at 36%. What I might do is see if I can't heal myself a little bit. Ooh, I got a healing potion, too. Alright, we killed it. My pet's still alive too, and I'm at 52% now, and this guy's at 35%, 30%. I'm gonna beat him. So there you go, I was able to solo 3 Sarnix, like, I think, what was it, 2 blues and a yellow? I have the worst memory. So there we go, let's heal up. I'm glad light healing did the trick. It helped that I had some of these nice buffs. I had a damage shield, Legacy of Spike. I have Kura's focusing. I don't seem to have like a temperance. Usually with all the buffs you get temperance. I mean, why would I need Talisman of the Serpent? I really don't need that as a Beast Lord. I need Temperance for the extra hit points. Don't know why I don't have that. Pardon. So, back to full hit points. So anyway, that's going to be my video for today. It was just going on about Project Lazarus and that I believe it deserves a chance, and I'm probably going to try to play on it a little more. If I discover any cool new things about it, I'll try to make videos and share. I'm also need to cure whatever the hell this disease is that I've been struck with. Damn it. Insidious Fever. Oh, I was casting down on my pet like a retard. Okay, there we go. We got rid of the Insidious Fever. Let's get the pet summoning spell back up just to be safe. Pet dies, you want to have another pet spell ready to cast it if you need it. So there we go. That's going to end the video. Sorry for the poor quality, especially the sound. I know sound is usually key, but I figured I just wanted to throw this one out there. And I can always replace it with something else later. I don't know. I just want to keep my video thing going. I've been steady now. putting one out every Sunday about noon. And some people are actually watching and interacting, and I really love that. Thank you. So I hope it is keeps up. I don't ever expect I'll be monetized, but hey, if I am, who knows? It might equal an extra 5 cents a month or something. I don't know. I don't. It's just fun to do for me. It's a nice hobby. So thank you for watching, and keep playing EverQuest.